Hey, champ. Long time no see. You here to cash in on some more tips from a certified locker room vet?
Yeah, I was wondering, how do I get a match?
Great question. From my experience, matches get booked in one of two ways. Talking to people, or checking your social media messages.
Checking my social media? So I guess I shouldn't go dark on there while I'm in WWE.
Definitely not. Even a veteran like me is always seeing what kind of trouble I can brew up on social media. If you don't check your SMs and DMs, you might miss out on opportunities. Not everything there will lead to a match, but it's worth keeping up with what the WWE universe is up to.
Okay, so check my social media feed and direct messages. Got it. And what did you mean by talking to people?
Exactly what it sounds like. Aside from being booked by management, talking with superstars, the crew, or other backstage visitors can lead to opportunities. Sometimes people might have favors to ask of you. Others might have bones to pick. You know how they say it's who you know? That's definitely true in WWE. Who you know and who you talk to.
Seems easy enough.
Don't try to put too much on your plate, though. If somebody wants a favor, you can always tell them no and come back to it later. Or even defuse a tense situation. But once you agree to something, you'll need to see it through.
So, one issue at a time. That makes sense.
All right. Any other questions, or anything you'd like me to explain again?
How do I improve my in-ring skills around here?
It's like the old saying goes, practice makes perfect. The more matches and experience you have in WWE, the better. From there, it's usually up to you to determine how you want to apply what you've learned, whether it's improving your strength, getting better at submissions, or putting more power behind your punches. You get the idea.
You said it's usually up to me what I want to improve.
Yep. Sometimes certain kinds of matches will benefit you in a more specific sort of way. But if that's the case, you'll know that going in. Sports entertainer insight, I call it.
Okay, cool.
All right. Any other questions or anything you'd like me to explain again?
Actually, I think I'm good for now.
All right. Well, like I said, if you ever need advice, or even if you just forgot your flip-flops for the shower, I'm here for you.
Got it.
Want to join my book club? I tried to recruit Robert Roode, but he said the only part of a book he likes is the ending. Or, as he called it, the book's finishing move. He said he's got the best ending in WWE, but I thought maybe you could take him on and show him yours?
The man destined to be top dog, it's The Lock.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 600 pounds, the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Bernstorm, Bob Blacksmith!
What title do you see next for the Intercontinental Champ, Corey?
Patience, Saxton, which is something you need as well as The Lock if he wants to add to his title collection.
Turn out the lights and close the doors behind you. It's time to lock up.
Glorious!
shows up, in the ring or on the entrance ramp.
Because nobody makes an instant impact quite like Robert Roode does. He's held the NXT title, Tag Team Championship, the United States title. Robert Roode is all business.
Robert Roode has tasted success both as a tag team competitor and in singles action.
And you know, Byron, he's proved he's dangerous in any situation, any night of the week.
Yeah, like it or not, Michael, Robert Roode has made a career out of making the most out of his opportunities.
Roode is a serious threat to any superstar, and Robert Roode is always ready to get his hands dirty.
The Intercontinental Champion and Robert Roode apparently have unfinished business, and they're settling it here on Raw in a finisher match.
Anyone else ever heard Roode say he's got the best finisher in WWE?
Constantly. But I think he's in for a rude awakening against The Lock.
Oh, not to the belly!
Oh, this is gonna hurt.
Really just laying it in.
Well-placed kick. Oh, this is going to be nasty. Full Nelson Slay. And Locke got turned around there.
Takedown. Looking for the crossface. Gets cinched in. This could be over. This won't win.
Looking to free the arm and does just that.
He might be finding a submission hold here.
I'm going to tap out here, but it ain't going to matter.
He'll still do a lot of damage, though.
A single leg camel clutch and a great counter.
What a drop kick.
He's lost some of his win now.
There's not much room out there.
DDT face first.
Robert Roode is short.
Okay, he is not going to let him make a mockery of things.
Oh, man, meeting the barricade. Look at this raw power. Oh, watch this display of power. Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious. And slam. Flat out power.
Wow.
A deadlift military press.
Holy moly.
Longer display of power. Maintaining the advantage now.
Yeah, Locke's proving hard to keep up with.
Whoa! Countering with a chop block will alter any attack.
Kick to the gut.
Dragged around into a neck breaker.
And there's a neck breaker.
He's got him here. He's got him up.
And oh!
He's getting pushed out into the defensive.
This is where endurance becomes so important in the late stages of the match.
Powerless position to be in right now.
Rocket power slam!
Whip back into the ring.
This
off from the rope. And this one might be headed ringside.
Bringing out that kendo stick means he is...
Okay, consider that a harsh lesson.
Great counter!
A kendo stick wrapped around the head.
Put into the corner now. Uncorked a big punch.
Charging up the arm. And, ooh, what a clothesline in the corner.
Power slam.
And we see him take yet another shot to the body.
Oh, my, what a splash. The end is looming now.
This is a very dangerous situation now.
Rue can't be feeling glorious right now.
Oh, he's in trouble, Byron.
He's able to sidestep there.
Getting back into the ring.
Hooked up. Coming fancy there, spinning Uranagi.
Can Rue withstand much more of this?
Rue needs to find a spark.
And got away with that.
This won't win the match, but it's doing a lot of damage in the process.
Looking to free the arm and does just that.
Flinged across the leg.
Taken down by the neck. Oh, look at the well-placed elbow right on the mark. Stomping the arm.
Rude's being stopped. Dangerous situation.
Thanks for coming.
Oh, wow. Rendered unconscious. The official has to call him.
Here is your winner.
Burnstorm.
Blacksmith.
Ended this match with a big win under his belt.
Rude lost? What was I getting all those hallelujahs for?
Practice?
Happy Corbin has been mouthing off about his football career more than usual lately, saying the WWE grind is the same as nonstop two-a-days, which is why he's so well-equipped. Give me a break. Take him off.
Yeah. bell.
Welcome to Raw. Gotta say, I've been a fan of your work for a while. Can't say the same for Drew Gulak, though. I heard him mention your name in a rant about superstars who lack fundamentals. Fundamentals according to who, Drew? But if you ever want to put in a little extra super-specific training before a show, you know who to ask.
That's three. Bell.
I just interviewed Ludwig Kaiser, who said WWE matches aren't enough of a test, so he's now proposing a 5 out of 9 falls match. Management hates the idea and would love it if someone could take him out in a 2 out of 3 falls match to shut him up. Interested?
Take a good look at the new face of WWE, it's The Lock.
The following contest is a 2 out of 3 falls match. Making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 600 pounds, the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Bernstorm, Bob Blacksmith.
After an exhilarating WWE debut, The Lock is looking to build on his early momentum.
The Intercontinental Champion will also be looking to lock up his reputation as the winner here tonight.
The Lock has been handed the keys to WWE. Is he ready to drive? Audacious mouthpiece of Imperium, Ludwig Kaiser. A man with over a decade of experience looking to continue his dominance in WWE.
And his opponent, representing Imperium, from Hamburg, Germany, weighing in at 220 pounds. Ludwig Kaiser!
A piercing look on his face.
No nonsense, all business.
You know, I was minding my own business backstage, and this guy stared me down and then yelled at me to move out of his way.
Bravo, Ludwig. No matter who you are, Ludwig Kaiser is a truly intimidating opponent.
Now, practically unflappable, strict and regimented.
And there's such precision in everything he does.
Champion is taking on the German sensation Ludwig Kaiser in a 2 out of 3 falls battle of endurance tonight.
You think that's endurance? I heard this was originally supposed to be a 5 out of 9 falls match.
Well, this is probably a good time to make sure we have overtime written into our contracts.
And stomping away in the corner.
Just ruthless.
This is going to be nasty.
For Nelson into the slam.
Scoop slam from behind. Boom. He's looking a little off balance. What are you doing here, Corey? The elbow forces the break.
Great effort, though.
Forced out of the ring.
He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
Moves outside. What's the plan here? Put in a position now.
attention to you, Saxton. They're too busy beating the tar out of each other. Oh, step up, Enziguri. He's got him scouted. Kick right to the ribs.
And there's more to come.
Brainbuster. He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
All the way up. And the
big time powerbomb. Could be some collateral damage on the way here.
Everyone needs to clear out, including us.
He's ejected from the ring. He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by countout.
Whoa!
Oh, my goodness.
Ooh-wee.
Fight is so close to our announce table.
Yeah, I'm just going to step aside now.
Hey, wait for me.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
Ludwig was ready for that.
Dominating cross body. Cover!
And a quick kick out.
We're well into the match, and he still seems so fresh. It's almost unbelievable.
Able to sidestep it.
This is what you get when you have complete confidence and control of the situation.
Wow, look who it is.
Sammy, what happened to your neck?
Don't get cute with me. You know exactly what happened. I had no idea who I was facing, and as a result, I lost, suffering emotional and physical damages after you assaulted me with that safe. I am going to sue you for everything you're worth.
I'd rather take you on in the ring than in the courtroom, but it doesn't look like you're in any condition to do that.
No, I'm not, thanks to you and your shenanigans. But maybe we can work something out. I won't sue under the following conditions. First, when I'm ready, I get a rematch for my title. And second, you no longer use the safe as part of your entrance, as it will cause further emotional distress, putting me at an unfair disadvantage.
I actually already told management I was done with the safe. Anyway, just let me know when you're ready to lose to me again.
I will, but it won't be a loss for me. And in the meantime, I have one other condition to prevent legal action. First, you must face my hand-picked opponent so I can rest up and do some extra scouting.
sure. Who do you want me to go up against?
Oh, you'll find out in the ring. Not a great feeling when you don't know who you're facing, is it? Good luck.
It's a superstar who's a lock to be on top of WWE for years to come.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 600 pounds, the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Barnstorm Bob Blacksmith.
That Intercontinental Championship looks good on the Rock, doesn't it?
He won it in his debut and hasn't looked back. Anything can happen tonight. All's fair in Lock and War.
By Sami Zayn, representing the Brawling Brutes from the United Kingdom, weighing in at 253 pounds, Ridge Holland!
A top competitor in professional rugby for over a decade before joining WWE.
It's tough enough to even survive professional rugby for a decade. You know that old adage, speak softly and carry a big stick? Well, it certainly applies to this man.
Holland going to let his power speak for him tonight. After his spectacular debut, the Intercontinental Champion will look to keep his momentum going tonight against Sami Zayn's hand-picked opponent, Ridge Holland.
Looks like Ridge Holland has company, though. Sami Zayn has apparently opted to rehab his neck at ringside.
Buckle up, folks. The Lock's title might not be up for grabs, but his reputation would certainly take a hit if he takes a step backwards here tonight.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious.
Plan until they get punched in the mouth. Well, someone just threw their plan out the window.
Power slam.
Now he's been put on the defensive.
It's nothing he hasn't been through before.
Oh, what do they got planned here?
Half Nelson applied. Uranagi.
Oh, my goodness. Got the full Nelson.
Slam!
Oh! Look at this, just stop after stop after stop.
Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
Gentlemen, in the interest of self-preservation, I may have to excuse myself. Saxton, you hang tight, let this play out.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
Ooh!
And Locke gets surprised there. Oh, timely counter by Locke.
Kick right to the ribs. And there's more to come.
Brain Buster.
Oh.
Oh, right into the shoulder. That's gotta hurt.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
That'll break his arm. Vicious.
German suplex. But that's not all. Into a ripcord lariat. What?
Going for the pin.
One, two. Sami Zayn just blindsided the lock with his chain.
This was all a setup to weaken the Intercontinental Champion before he faces Sami Zayn.
Did Sami say something about the safe?
Could be some kind of revenge for what happened when the lock debuted.
With the deranged Sami Zayn calling the shots, nothing is off limits.
Well, whatever the plan is, Sami looks to be maneuvering the lock toward the stage.
And the lock's helpless after taking that blow from his own chain.
And there it is. Ridge Holland has brought out the lock safe.
What the heck is their plan?
Belly to belly suplex on the unforgiving stage.
Now what are they gonna do?
Is Sami Zayn trying to tip the safe over on top of the lock?
Those things weigh like 1,000 pounds. This is way worse than what the lock did to Sami.
Our Intercontinental Champion's gonna be seriously injured.
This is bad.
Especially with both of them pushing it now.
I don't think I can watch this.
Gabriel Slade is here.
Thankfully, he's going to put an end to this.
Yeah, Sami and Ridge want no part of him.
Well, no idea if these two are friends. Maybe Slade just didn't want to see someone get squashed.
Well, Locke certainly looks frustrated with himself, or Gabriel Slade, or maybe all of the above.
He should just be happy he's walking out of here on his own 2 feet and not getting peeled off the stage.